Welcome back to my channel. My name's Claire. So today we're talking about simplifying our sewing experience. So I don't know about you, but over the years I've started to hoard things. I think the more I sew, the more stuff I've got about, and it's got to the point where I cannot think straight. So I am in a process of decluttering. So as I was thinking about that, I thought it might be useful to talk to you about some ways in which we can simplify our sewing. Let's get into it. So the first way that I suggest that you simplify your sewing is to actually go right down to the base of it and declutter or organise your wardrobe. Because you know what? It's really hard to assess what you need to sew if you don't know what you've got. Up until last year, I was really guilty of that. I had the rail out that you would have seen in my old videos, where I just had loads and loads of clothes on the rail, most of which I never ever wore, perhaps because they didn't fit me as I liked, or they weren't my style anymore. Lots and lots of reasons. So at the end of last year, I did do a really brutal declutter of my clothes, to the point I've only got 4 or 5 outfits now, and we're going to rectify that real soon. It really helped me to see that I wasn't wearing most of the clothes that I had hanging up in my wardrobe or on my rail. The things that I found the most helpful for decluttering my wardrobe was not only removing clothes that I didn't use and thus clearing up space in my very small apartment, but it also cleared up space in my mind. It's really weird how that works, don't you think? I found I could focus a lot more clearly once I had decluttered my wardrobe. The next thing I found really helpful in order to simplify my sewing process is to organise my sewing patterns and fabric. Maybe one or two of you are not hoarders and this won't apply to you, but for most of us, from the comments and the posts that I see written online, we're buying loads and loads of patterns, we're buying more fabric than we can ever use, and it's taking up a lot of space. You know, I have plenty of fabrics. Well, I used to, until I decluttered my fabrics. You may remember I did a complete declutter video on here and I sold a lot of my fabrics. I still have a little bit left from that, but not much at all. And that was really, really helpful. I had the Calyx unit in here where I had all my fabrics on show. Got to the point where I didn't want it on show anymore. So the idea of putting it on show was to have it very visually pleasing. And then after that, it started to cause anxiety, whereby if I'd look at it, I'd be looking at all the fabrics that I've had for years and years and years that I've never used. And to be quite frank, didn't know if I ever would use it. Around like October, November last year, I had my Calyx unit in the corner and my sewing machine, and it just was looking so cluttered and I was getting fed up of it. So I decluttered my fabric and I've sold many, many sewing patterns. Obviously you can't sell your PDF patterns, but if you do have paper patterns that you know you're not going to use, or you've already used and you won't use again, then stash them. Let someone else have some love from them that you're just not giving that love to them right now. So someone else can really benefit from them. You might get a couple of pounds or dollars in the process, but not only that, you're going to free up space in your room and in your mind. Like when you then go to choose a pattern or a fabric, you've got less choice, and it will be a much simpler process for you. Believe me, you will thank me for this. You really, really will. So the next thing I think is going to be really beneficial to you in order to simplify your sewing process is that once you have removed or organised your wardrobe, to take the time to do an audit or assess what you have in your wardrobe and what you actually need. So I do have a video where I talk more in depth about this process and I offer a free download in that one. So do check that video out. It will be linked down below. I know that once I assessed what I had in my wardrobe, or what I didn't have in my wardrobe, I was then able to assess the things that I can really prioritise making. Now, I did another video at the beginning of the year where I talked about this, about like choosing what to make, and I was very much focused on making what you need rather than what you want to. We see the pattern and we absolutely love it and we want to make it, and then we wear it once or twice, and I was really focused on making what you need. So if that interests you, that video will also be linked down below, because that might actually help you. I know it did help a lot of people. So once you've worked out what you want, and then you've gone through the process of looking for patterns and looking for fabric, it's going to be so much easier. It's just going to remove a lot of the noise from choosing the pattern. I know myself from previously wanting to make a pattern, there was so much choice out there, it became really, really confusing. And by going through this process, you are reducing that confusion. So this next idea, I haven't actually done myself yet, but it is something, well, I have done it for certain things, not garment sewing. I've done it for bra making and for bag making, but I haven't done it for garment sewing. That is, once you've decided on your pattern and you've got your fabric, to then create a project crate. So by that, I mean just get a little tub, or even a plastic bag or something like that. Whatever you've got to hand, don't buy anything special. All you've got to do is collect all of your supplies up together and put them in that bag ready for using. The reason I think this is a really good thing to do, and I found this in bag making especially, is that I would start cutting out my fabric for bags. And then I'd start sewing, and halfway through sewing, I'm like, oh, I need a D-ring. I haven't got a D-ring. I'm going to have to order a D-ring, and it's going to take me days and days for waiting for it to arrive. Whereas if I had collected all my supplies before I started, I would have everything there. And then when I start, there's no interruptions, and you can just go. So if you transfer that to garment sewing, so if you're making a dress that needs a zip, or maybe it needs some poppers, or you need to buy a matching thread, you can work all that out when you're collecting it in your little project bag. So I really think that might be quite beneficial, and it will be something that I try out in the future. And leading on from that, the next thing that's going to simplify your life is to batch sew projects. This is going to be very, very based on your personality, I think, because I did try this years ago. I saw someone else who batch sewed, and they were able to achieve such a lot through batch sewing. And so I gave it a go, and it wasn't personally for me, but I can totally see the benefit of other people doing it. And maybe it is something that I will revisit in the future. It's a really good way of sewing. If you sew a lot, and you know what projects you've got coming up, you know, because you've decluttered your wardrobe, you've assessed what fabric you've got, you know what you're doing, you're very, very organised at this point. Batch sewing is just the next step. It's the obvious next step to do. And that might be spending an afternoon cutting out all your fabrics for all your projects you've got coming up. And then the next day, maybe applying the interfacing, or doing the hems, or just batch sewing all your jobs. There is nothing more simple than doing that. It's a little bit factory line for me. So I made my husband 4 shirts, including a toile. I had all these fabrics that I wanted to make him shirts in, so I cut them all out and put them aside to then sew. And then I sewed one at a time. But the thing is, by the time I got through the second one, I was so over this pattern that I didn't do it. Am I talking you out of this? I don't think so. I hope not. This is just how my personality works. I have seen it be successful for so many other people. So don't dismiss it just because it didn't work for me. So the next thing I think is really going to simplify your sewing life, probably more than anything else that I'm going to talk about, is to stop hoarding supplies. So this is something I stopped about a year ago now. I was more guilty than anyone else, honestly. I really was. I just go shopping. If I had a spare £50, not that I ever really had a spare £50, but if I convinced myself I had a spare £50, then I would go shopping to buy fabric. There'd be no project in mind whatsoever. I would just be browsing for fabrics that I absolutely love, buy them, and then I'd be too scared to use them because I love them too much. It was just ridiculous. And to be fair, I didn't smoke, I didn't drink, I didn't go out socialising, I didn't go on holidays. So this was the thing that gave me pleasure. But looking back, I just kind of feel it was a little bit unnecessary, the amount I was purchasing. I just feel, but not only I feel, I know that if you stop doing all of that, if you are, perhaps you're more sensible than I was, but if you are similar to how I used to be, your life will improve if you stop it. You might not believe me, but it's true. You will. So about a year ago, I stopped it. The main reason initially I stopped it is I didn't have the income that I had previously, so I had to stop it. It took a while. It was almost like an addiction. Well, I stopped straight away because I had to. I didn't have the money to buy the things, but it took a while to feel comfortable with not purchasing the things. Now I buy on a need basis only, and in a lot of cases I just make do. So about once a year I will buy some fabric. Those fabrics and the fabrics that I had from the past will last me for the year. And I'm quite strict on myself now. I only buy them once. I do a little fabric haul once a year. And the year's almost up, so I can buy some more fabric soon. So yay me. But it is stuff that I will use and I will create a plan. If you're loving this video, can I just ask that you give me a like and a comment down below? Because those things really, really help, as you're well aware by now, because I mention it in nearly every video. But if you could, that would be fantastic. Don't forget to subscribe if you do like videos like this, because I've got lots more coming. So this next one, I didn't know whether to include it because it flies in the face of one of my previous pieces of advice. So where I said to batch sew, that can be really helpful. This one also depends on your personality, but concentrate on one project at a time. I know, I'm saying batch record and then I'm saying concentrate on one piece, but it's not either or, it's really whichever one works with your personality. Now concentrating on one project at a time is what works for me. So what I tend to do is if I'm gonna make a project, I will put the PDF together, I'll do the twirl, and etc, etc, you know the process. And I will try to do one thing at a time. I cannot go back and forth between projects. I just cannot do it. Maybe the brain fog's to blame for that, I don't know. But I cannot go back through projects, backwards and forwards. It drives me mad. Also, if you're doing one project at a time, then you are going to finish your project in a much quicker time period. Is that not going to simplify your life? Especially as we all love to finish projects really quickly, don't we? I don't know why we do, but we love that instant gratification. Yes, it only took me 1 hour to sew a t-shirt, or it only took me 3 hours to make a dress. There's some sort of like internal accolade that we give ourselves when we do that, and I don't know why, because as I've spoken about in my video I did a couple of weeks ago about my sewing behaviours, I think that it's quite a good idea to just take the time. But if you are someone who likes to have a quick turnaround with your makes, then concentrating on one project at a time is really going to simplify your sewing process. So the next thing that might simplify your sewing process, if you're someone that likes to use social media quite a lot, then removing that noise from your life can be very, very beneficial. I think when we're viewing other accounts online, it can be very easy to take on other people's influence, to like see them in the perfect dress with the perfect figure and think, oh, why can't I have that? Then you search high and low for something that's gonna make you look like that, even if nothing ever will make you look like that. At the very, very least, it's going to use up time that you could be sewing. I think by not absorbing other people's social media, then you are going to stay on track, You've decided, you've decluttered your wardrobe, you know what you need or want to make, you've got a pattern for it, you've got your fabric for it, you've either batch sewed or you're concentrating on this one project. If you then go and look on social media, you're going to start questioning your own decisions and then think, oh, maybe I want to make that other thing that that's just been released 3 days ago. Oh, I must make that thing right now. And then you have to go back to the drawing board, even though you may have started sewing something else. So just remove that white noise of social media from your life, at least while you're sewing patterns. So I'm very, very guilty of this, but sometimes when we want to sew a project, we might want to do a dress, which we know is an involved make, and it's going to take the best part of a whole day. If you work on it for half a day at a time, or even just a couple of hours at a time, it might take longer and it can feel quite daunting. So this next point is, if you've got a spare half an hour, do something towards that project that is going to help you in the long run. So it might be in the beginning that you just need to choose your fabric and you've got half an hour. So you can go through your fabrics and decide, or if you haven't got the right fabric, you can go and order it online. Or maybe if you've only got half an hour, you can put your PDF together or cut your fabrics out or just sew a collar or make some kind of progress. So if you only have 30 minutes, you can either sit there and think, oh, I've got no time to myself, and then it's going to be 2 weeks before you can start on your project, or you can do 30 minutes a day doing those little jobs each day, and by the end of the 2 weeks you've got your garment, and then you can, when you have got time to do a full garment, you can make something else. That is definitely advice that I need to listen to. I think part of the reason I don't sew more lately is because I get a little bit overwhelmed with all the work that is involved in it, because obviously I am putting a lot of effort into these videos, which has increased my workload significantly. So I need to listen to my own advice with this one, but there will be at least 2 makes coming up this month. I'm making that promise to you and to myself, because I really need some more clothes. I hope you found some inspiration in this video and that it was helpful to you. It may be, or you may already have a really simplified sewing life, I don't know, but hopefully if you haven't and you're someone who needs a little bit of help with organisation, that this will help you. I know I could have done with this advice a little while ago, but I am making strides with it now. So until next time, happy sewing. Bye for now.